Good evening, and welcome to another edition of the Yuba Sutter Medical Explorer. I'm Dr. Robert Peppercorn. My specialty is dermatology. I will be serving as host of this program. The purpose of the Medical Explorer is to explore the medical communities of Yuba and Sutter counties, and to take you behind the scenes of medical care practices in our local area. We have another interesting show for you tonight as we commemorate Better Hearing and Speech Month. Tonight, we will meet audiologists and visit their offices at the Marysville Medical Clinic. This section of our program will demonstrate many of the new modern techniques that we have today to test hearing. Before getting to our topic tonight, let's start with some interesting medical news. The American Medical Association's Council on Scientific Affairs has reported new evidence that chronic brain damage occurs commonly in prize fighters. As a result, editorials in the Journal of the American Medical Association have called for increased boxing controls. The journal's editor said, "No caring person could have observed the events in professional prize fighting in the past few months and not have been revolted. No prudent physician could have watched the most recent mismatch between Larry Holmes and Randall Tex Cobb and believe the current boxing control system is functioning properly." A radiology research group examined 38 former boxers by CT scanning. Over one half showed brain tissue atrophy, which can lead to a syndrome commonly referred to as being punch drunk. The data suggested that brain atrophy is more common in fighters with a greater number of fights. However, it also showed that a fighter with a moderate number of bouts may also sustain brain damage. The AMA's council showed that some of this boxing should be banned completely, but agreed that for the moment, this is not a realistic solution. The council urged stricter medical supervision of boxing. They also recommended that each fight be observed by a ringside physician who would have the authority to stop the fight if indicated by the boxer's physical condition. Now, on with the Medical Explorer. Have you or your family ever been faced with a difficult task of talking to a relative who seems to have a hearing problem? Do you remember the shouting matches when you tried to get them to understand some important statement or some important piece of information? Have you ever wondered how today people test hearing and what someone has to go through to get their hearing tested? Let's take a look at what modern technology has to offer someone who needs a thorough, complete hearing evaluation. I'm standing in the audiology department of the Marysville Medical Clinic in Marysville. Today we're going to witness how someone comes in to have their hearing tested when there's a problem. We've heard about a patient. Her name is Linda. She was told by her family that they're unable to communicate with her very well. They have to shout whenever they want to tell her something. They also noticed at home that she keeps her television volume up so high that everybody has to leave the room because the volume is up so high. But no one's been able to convince her that she has a hearing problem. So her family practitioner recommended that she come over to the audiology department here in Marysville and meet Mr. Lind for some hearing testing.
Hi, Linda. Come on in. I understand you're having some trouble with your hearing.
Well, my family says so. I don't really think I do.
Okay. Why don't you sit right up here in this chair in the little sound booth there, and we'll try to find out what kind of hearing problem you have. You're going to be listening to some very soft tones, first on the right side, then on the left side. And all you have to do is raise your hand or your finger every time you hear the sound. Now, they're very faint most of the time, so even if you just barely hear it, it's okay to raise your hand. Does one ear seem to be better than the other ear, or can you hear equally?
I don't think so. I think I hear equally well.
We'll try the right side first. Is hearing a series of pure tones. It's not a natural sound, but it's a sound that's easy to test with. And as they get lower and lower, she will stop responding. And we just test individual frequencies, try to determine which sounds she hears and which sounds she doesn't hear. And we can draw a graph when the test is completed. find out if her hearing is within normal limits for any of the sounds, or for all of the sounds, for that matter. She appears to have a moderate hearing loss on her right ear. Approximately equal for all the sounds. I'll go ahead and try the other ear, same thing. This is probably the most basic hearing test, and it's fairly easy to perform on most adults and children, for that matter, down to the age of 3 or 4.
Mr. Lind, the audiologist, has just finished testing Linda's hearing, and now they're going to meet and discuss the results.
Linda, you do have a hearing loss on both sides. Your right ear is a little bit worse than the left ear, and it's relatively equal for all the different sounds that you were listening to. The results indicate that it's conductive type of hearing loss, which means it's fairly simple in most cases, and it's like your ear was plugged up. It may not sound that way to you now, probably because it's been that way for some time, but these kinds of hearing losses generally can be treated medically and resolved, at least for the most part. Your next step now would be to go back to your family physician and take him the test results. I'll write him a letter so he'll know what's going on, and hopefully he will take care of the hearing problem. And if he can't, or if he doesn't feel like he wants to handle that type of thing, he'll refer you to one of the ear, nose, and throat specialists in the area.
Rick, we've heard a lot about this new equipment that the Marysville Medical Clinic purchased, this machine behind me. I understand it costs $20,000, but I don't really know what it's all about. Tell us about, what is this machine, Rick, and what does it actually do?
This is called the Brainstem Evoke Potential, or Evoke Response Machine, and it does quite a few different things. It can test certain functions of the brain, not only as far as hearing goes, but for vision and sense of touch also. As an audiologist, I'm mainly interested in the hearing portion of it. And what it enables us to do is monitor the brain's response to sound without the patient having to make a response himself. You saw in the earlier test how the patient had to raise his hand or her hand to the tone. This does not require any participation on the patient's part at all. We can test infants that are days old, or we can test people that are, say, in a coma in the hospital. They don't have to make any kind of response, and we can tell certain things about the integrity of the hearing system.
So in the story of Helen Keller, where she was a baby born without any hearing as well as other senses, you could have tested her with this machine, and at that point, 2 days old, have known that she had problems with her hearing.
Right, exactly.
So as they wouldn't have had to wait 3 years or 4 years to find out there was a problem, they wouldn't have had to have called her mentally retarded and all those things
right.
that they did,
right.
because you don't have to ask the patient, can you hear this? The machine itself can say they're hearing it or they're not hearing it.
Right.
That's
it
fantastic.
It doesn't give the same kind of results as the other hearing tests we did, but it can tell us an awful lot of information whether the patient hears at all, for instance. And with a newborn infant that you suspect to have a hearing loss, that sometimes is a real big help.
I see. We have a patient here, Carrie, who parents were telling us that she's had trouble with her hearing, as well as the fact that she's been stumbling, some dizziness problems around the house, and that words seem jumbled to her when she listens. And we're going to be able to test the lower part of her brain with this machine.
Right.
Well, let's get started.
Okay, here we go.